In this video, we will demonstrate how to edit Dolby Vision in DaVinci Resolve for social media. To do that, we will use the setup variant with the MacBook Pro and integrated XDR display. To learn about possible setup options, go to the first part of this video linked in the description. In Resolve, open the project settings and navigate to the master settings. Set the timeline resolution to 3840 by 2160 Ultra HD. Set the frame rate to match the output frame rate, which usually matches the frame rate of your footage. Then, navigate to Color Management and select Color Science DaVinci YRGB Color Managed. Set the color processing mode to HDR and the output color space to HDRPQ. These settings enable Resolve to uniformly convert your source material to HDR for output. Next, check Enable Dolby Vision and set the mastering display to 1000 nits, BT2020, D65, ST2084, full. These settings will enable Dolby Vision encoding functionality during export. Press Save and go to the Media tab. Import the source material into the media pool. Avoid using 8-bit Rec. 709 SDR footage, as it limits the potential of HDR. For this video, we use some content shot with an iPhone and Dolby Vision, some footage shot with a V-Log camera and hybrid log gamma, and some content shot with a DSLR camera shot using S-Log 3. We recommend that you arrange your sources in different folders within the media pool and verify that Resolve recognizes the correct input color space of your captured content. This way, Resolve can properly manage content from source to display. The iPhone content is correctly identified as HLG Rec 2100. The footage from the V-Log camera is correctly tagged as HLG Rec 2020. And the footage from the DSLR camera is also correctly tagged as Sony S-Log 3. Now, you can edit as usual, and all content will display correctly in HDR on the viewer, even though it came from different camera sources and was shot in different formats using different color spaces. When your edit is finished, you may want to make your content stand out and do some color correction. To assess the luminance and contrast of your content, use Resolve's built-in waveform monitor. Since you're working in HDR, go to the Options menu and set the waveform scale style to HDR. The units on the y-axis will present values from 0 to 10,000 nits. These nits indicate how bright your image will be. For a pleasing image display, you should avoid clipping both highlights and shadows unless you want to do so intentionally. Resolve will automatically limit the output to 1,000 nits. To insert a graphic element, go back to the Edit page. This element has been created in Rec. 709, which is SDR. Right-click and verify that Resolve identifies this source correctly. This is critical for an automatic conversion of the SDR content to HDR. Now, we will create a title in Resolve and resize it to best fit the background. Then, we are going to make this title a compound clip to adjust its luminance via the Color tab. For text elements, as well as graphic elements, a luminance between 200 and 400 nits works well. Resolve's waveform scopes make it easy to set these values. Open the waveform settings and enable Show Reference Levels. Set the low level to 200 and the high level to 400. Now, you can easily adjust the luminance of the title within this range. Depending on the content, you can also go above or below this range. To export your content, navigate to the Deliver page. At the top of the Render Settings window, select H.265. Choose a file name and browse to the location where you want to save the encoded file. Either leave the format set as QuickTime or set it to MP4. Ensure that the codec is always set to H.265 and leave the Use Hardware Acceleration if Available option enabled, as this setting speeds up the rendering process. Leave quality set to automatic or adjust the bitrate based on the specifications of the social media platform you intend to upload to. Now, navigate to Advanced Settings. Leave data levels set to auto and also leave color space tag and gamma tag set to same as project. To select your specific rendering needs, scroll down to the Dolby Vision profile. For this video, we will select Profile 8.4 as this format is supported by all social media platforms that support Dolby Vision. This profile will generate frame-by-frame metadata during encoding and is cross-compatible with hybrid log gamma devices, so it can also be uploaded to platforms that currently support generic HDR but do not yet support Dolby Vision. This format is also used by iPhone and Android smartphones when recording in Dolby Vision HDR. Once all the settings are made, add the job to the render queue and start encoding. Now, the encoded file can be easily shared and played back on a TV, smartphone, tablet, or any other device that supports Dolby Vision playback. You can also copy this encoded file to a USB flash drive and connect it to a Dolby Vision-enabled TV for review. Once you have verified the export on your Dolby Vision-compliant device, you should also check the file metadata to make sure it meets the specifications of the social media platform. You can either use QuickTime Player and press Command I to get some basic information, or use an app such as Media Info, which provides even more detailed information on the file metadata. Once you have completed your review, you can upload your Dolby Vision content to the social media platform of your choice.